Hey everyone, I'm Dana Carmel, songwriting teacher based in Brooklyn, New York, and I am so passionate about helping people channel their creativity into music. That is how I channel my creativity into music and into songwriting, and I hope to be your trusted source for holistic songwriting here on YouTube. If you want to work with me one-on-one, go to danacarmel.com. You can find out how to do that there. And then any other sources or resources that I use in the lessons will be in the caption notes. So let's get started with our lesson. Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to another episode of Life of a Songwriter with your host, me, Dana Carmel. This is an episode of Songs I Wish I Wrote. This one's so good. This one's I'm really excited about. It's a little bit different. It's different than what I've done in the past. It's a genre that you maybe like, but maybe you're not that familiar with. It's a song that you most likely have not heard. And what song is that? It's called Bring Me to Life. It's by Mark Kinchin, otherwise known as MK, featuring Millie Pye. It's produced by Mark Kinchin. It's a house song. I don't know if you know this about me, but I love house music, and especially really good house music. And this song is a song that was produced in 2015. It's funny, I was just on the YouTube video, and one of the comments of the YouTube video for this song was like, I don't know why this song wasn't a huge, massive hit. And I echo that sentiment 100%. I don't know why this song is not like a huge, massive hit. Again, I know it's old. It's coming up on 10 years. But this song is a song that I never, ever get sick of listening to. I have to give props to my brother because he's the one who turned me onto this song. And the reason that I really wanted to share it today is because, you know, the last couple weeks have been a little hard for me. I don't know if anybody else has been feeling that, but just kind of emotionally, physically feeling tired, I guess, but emotionally and mentally just feeling not my best. And, you know, it happens. I'm human. And this song is a song that I come to, like, when I'm coming out of it. Like, on the upswing, on the other side of it, which is, you'll see why that's actually pretty funny, just so, because some of the words. So this song is a song I listen to, and it just kind of pushes me into the other side. So we're not gonna do what we normally do with like the lyrics, whatever. I'm just gonna talk so about it, and we're gonna listen to it, and you're gonna get to hear this song that you've probably never heard before, and you know, you can listen for elements and things you like, things you don't like, but I just had to share this song in case you too are also maybe going through a spot the last couple weeks, and maybe you just need this really uplifting song, you know, as somebody who, you know, wants to educate and share new stuff. This is one of my favorite songs. Like I said, it never gets old. So, okay, here are the lyrics. Oh, it's so good. I can't even get over it. It's so good. Okay, I just came back from the other side, from the black-white world where the colors run dry. I mean, can we just have a pause for those words? From the black-white world where the colors run dry. Like, I just know what that is, right? Especially when I'm like, the last couple weeks, haven't been feeling like my best self. It feels like that. It feels like that black-white world, okay? And all my demons feel like they've disappeared tonight, like I just broke into the morning light. So this is like you're coming back from this other side, right? From this kind of down place. And then it's you bring me to life, you know, and then now the world looks so damn beautiful when you open up my eyes. You bring me to life, you know. And you're going to hear it. You're going to know why it, like, the music. I mean, we've talked about prosody, and I'm not going to talk about it that much here, but like the prosody of these words with what, you know, what she sings, how she sings and her voice, it's just so good. And yeah, I just came out of the darkest night. Hello, metaphor, where the strangers got me hypnotized. I mean, no one gets out of here alive, but today's not the day, not the day that I die. Maybe it sounds a little morbid, but like, again, you'll hear it. You know, no one gets out of here alive, right? Like, no one gets out of this life alive. And like, maybe those days were like dark. I mean, they weren't that dark, but you know, but today is not the day that I die, you know? And it's like, you bring me to life. And now this, I interpret this as actually being almost kind of like a spiritual song. Like maybe, you know, this person is talking to, like, you know, like the spirit or the universe or whatever, is like, you're bringing me back to life. that could be one interpretation. You can interpret it however, you know, it could be a romantic thing. It could just be like, life is bringing me back to life. But this song is really, it's just so good. I mean, it really captures all the feeling and the emotion of being in that place and then coming out of it and how good it feels to come out of it. Like, I remember some days in Brooklyn when I first heard it, like, I get really obsessed with songs. And so I remember I was just on this bike. I was on my bike and listening to the song on repeat, just like going fast through the streets, probably faster than I should have been. And this song literally on repeat, like I literally hit the button for it to just play over and over and over again. And it just, oh, it's just such a good feeling song. Especially, like I said, when I'm coming out of like a place where I don't feel so good. So without further ado, let's listen to this song. Listen, I might have some unique taste, but damn, that song just like is so, feels so good to me. And I just wanted to share that with you. I know it's a little different than the Kacey Musgrave song that I did last time, but what can I say? My range of songs that I love, just it really varies. And I wanted to offer this to you as just a feel-good song where like when you're coming out of it, out of a place where it's been hard, this, at least for me, this one is just like, it just helps me remember, right, that like I'm alive. It's bring me back to life. You bring me to life. Like, today's not the day that I died. Today, like, I'm alive, you know. I have a hat that says, like, holy shit, we're alive, right? It's like, that's this in a song. Yeah. So anyway, that's the song. Fucking enjoy, man. Go turn it up. Dance. You know, what I like to do, I put it in my headphones and, you know, it's like a listening. If this is not your jam, which is totally fine, you can use it as a way to just like practice active listening. Like, what do you hear, you know, when the drop comes? Like, what is it that makes the drop? You know, the differences in the drums. Yeah, just kind of just listen to see. But like, her voice just fucking slaps. Yeah, this song is just never gets old. So thank you, bro, for turning me on to this. Literally 10 years later, it's one of my favorites. So yeah, I think that's it for today. What more do you need than this uplifting song? Yeah, in summary, listen to the song. You can learn a lot from other genres and it just feels good to feel good. So I'm gonna leave you with that. You know, if you want more, of course you can go to danacromel.com. You can leave a comment below with your favorite aspect of this song or an element that stuck out to you, or maybe you didn't like it. That's okay. Do you have a favorite song that you go to when you're not feeling your best? Do you like to cry it out? Do you like to dance it out? What's your go-to move? And then of course, please hit subscribe, because I want, you know, more people to hear these kind of songs and just, you know, geek out with me on music, because this is one of my favorite things to do. So that's it for me. I'll catch you next time on Life of a Songwriter. Bye.